Welcome students. Today we are going to see the arrays algorithm, the lab program, okay, by using the Java code. So here the question is, write a program for simple RSA algorithm to encrypt and decrypt the data. Okay, so now here how we are going to do it, how we are going to work out. 1 minute. Okay, so how we are going to see. Okay, so what is the meaning of your RSA algorithm? RSA, already you know that it is a public key cryptography. So RSA is nothing but it is a public key cryptography, and it has been developed by Rivest, Shamir and Adelman. So this algorithm is used for public key encryption and the private key encryption and for all the digital signatures. And also we know that it's a security purpose we are using this RSA algorithm. Why it is more secured? Because it is every time it will be going for the factoring the large integer values. So you will have to remember that here we are using the large integer values to factorize it and to get the more security towards sending the message from one place to another place. So what will be the efficiency oriented thing? And also we know that this algorithm, it is a very fast method because it will perform the modular exponential operations. Okay, so how we are going to find out the modular exponential operations? We have to find out the mod values of the individual entities, whatever we have entered, and it will be very less efficient conventional in use, and also it will be always taking the power of your secret key and the public key, that is respectively E and D. So here we are going to get some of the remainder values, and straightforward we are applying the implementation to perform the operation sequentially. So here first we have to raise towards the power, and then we are going to apply the modulus value. So this, the steps for generating the key will be in this way. So first we have to take the two large random prime numbers, that is P and Q, which will be given, and that both things we are going to find out the product. So the product is going to store in N. So the value of your N will be P into Q. Next, we are going to compute the phi value, which is nothing but Euler's function. So by using this Euler's function, we are going to find out the phi value, pi of N, that is nothing but P minus 1 into Q minus 1. And then you have to choose any of the integer E, so that can be a prime number. You have to choose the E in such a way that the E will be greater than your 1 and less than the phi of N value. So that you can, if you are going to find out the GCD of E comma phi, you will be getting the answer as 1. So many times, as we have here, we have been used the large integer values. So we are going to use the keyword in our program as big integers. And you have to remember, as we are going to find out the value of 1, many places you will see we have been used the big integer dot 1. Okay. Afterwards, the next step will be to find out the secret exponent, that is your value of your D, where the value of your D will be greater than 1 and less than phi of N. You have to find out the value of D in such a way that E into D will be equal to 1 modulus phi. And also I have given you yesterday one more formula, that is 1 plus K into phi of N divided by E. So that formula you can apply if you are getting any question in your exam. But for the program, you have to use this formula. Both the formulas are same. It is not different. You can see here the both the formulas are same. It's not different. But the way of writing in program code will be little different when you are writing in the pen and paper. Afterwards, the next step and the last step will be finding out the public key. The public key will be nothing but this one will be the value of your E and N, and private key will be the value of your D and N. Once all these things will be fine, you got it, then you can show your values like P, Q and phi of n, everything you can show. So how we are going to process your encryption process? So sender A, through your sender A, you are going to process this. So you remember one thing, in this algorithm, in this program, we have to write two programs. The first program we are writing to generate the key, and the second program we are writing to generate the encryption and decryption key. So whatever the five steps have been written over here, that five steps we are going to write in the first program. Then again, by using the second program, we are going to encrypt and decrypt the data of RSA. So now what we are going to do, this is the steps to encrypt the data from the sender side. So from the sender side, the public key will be your E, N, which one is going to represent the plain text message for any positive integer message, that is your M. And we know the formula, how to calculate the ciphertext. We have to calculate the ciphertext by using this formula, M power of E modulo N. So the ciphertext will be received by the B. Okay. So how we are going to decrypt the message? In the receiver side, the B has the private key, that is D, N. And from here, we are going to compute the message. So how to find out the message? The message will be equal to ciphertext modulo D, power D, then modulo N. So from here, we are going to extract the plain text from the integer, whatever has provided here in the encryption time, the message. So if you are getting the message, same message, then you are going to get it properly. Then the program is correct. So now let's move towards the source code. The first one, you can see my screen here. That is two program. First one, I told you, we have to generate the key, RSA key generation. And again, I have to write one more program. That is my RSA encryption and decryption. So for that, what you're going to do is you have to create the Java program. Let's take the name of the Java program is, for the first one is RSA key generation. And for the second one, let's take it as your RSA encryption decryption. So let me explain the program first. I'm going individual words also. You can understand the program. See here, we have written, this is the first program, the source code of your RSA key generation. So to use the Java program, we need some of the package, the Java package, where our all the primitives, whatever we have been used, everything we can import it. So the first one I have used as util package, that is inside my Java. So I'm going to import the util package. So as the star is here, it means that all. So everything, all the primitives I'm going to import. The next one I have used, import Java math dot big integer. So here the big integer is nothing but it will help you to calculate for all the primitive data types. And as the integer values we are going to provide, so definitely everything will be the mathematical sequence. And why big has been written? Because everything we are going to calculate the more integer values. It is the highest integer values we are going to calculate. So many of the times what will happen, if we won't write, then big integers, whenever we are going to find out the power and all, it won't take. You have already done the RSA key algorithms problems. You know how to find out the powers and all. So when we will calculate, it will be a very big value. Okay, that is the reason we have to import the Java big integer mathematical package. Next one will be a Java language package. Again, it is a star, so everything we are going to import it. Next, the my class name. Whatever I'm giving my class name, same thing will be my Java file name. So you just remember, whatever the class name you have given, you have to save this program by taking your same class name itself. So the next step you can see, public static void main string arguments. So what is the meaning of your public? Public is nothing but this is your access specifier. Just note it down. If you cannot remember, I'm going slowly. Please note it down. So public is nothing but it is known as your access specifier. which is having the access publicly from the program. If you want to access something, so it will act as your access specifier. What do you mean by static? Static is known as your access modifier. Okay, so static is known as your access modifier. By using this, we can call the methods directly by the class name without creating any of the object. Okay, I just repeat once again. By using this static method or access modifier, we can call the methods. Okay, we can call the methods directly by the class name. What is the class name? RSA key generation. So by class name, without creating any of the object. Okay, so that is the meaning of your static. What is the meaning of your void? So void means it is a return type function. So void is a return type function. So now the next one is your main method. So main will act as your method. Now arguments. What is this arguments? In Java, we have to accept only string type. Okay, that's the reason I have written here string. We have to accept only the string type arguments and we have to store in the memory. That is the reason I have written here string argument s. Okay, now let's start with the program. Here the program goes according to your algorithm. Okay, little extra things has been written. So here the first one, you can see that I have written here the two random values, because you know whatever values we are going to give, everything will be a random values. Okay, so here these two sentence, the random values I have taken, and rand 1 and rand 2 will be the object of your random. So here the new keyword has been used to create the memory locations for your random 1. So what it is going to do? It is going to store the current time in milliseconds. Okay, so here these things we are using to find out the performance, how it is efficiently giving us. And for the random 2, I'm just multiplying it with the 10. This sentence is not there in your algorithm. We are writing it extra to find out the more efficiency towards the program. Next line is integer public key. So this public key is a variable name. And inside this public key, whatever the argument 0, 0 in the sense the first bits of data, whatever it will be in a string type. I told you that always your Java will accept the string type of data. So whatever the string type of data has come first, so that is a 0th place. Okay, so 0, that time everything has to be converted into integer type by using this parse int. So here, these things are going to parses as your, the strings are going to parses towards this to convert it into the integer types, because we want the public key in integer type. So we have converted into integer type and stored inside your public key. Next step is we want the two values, that is P value and the key value, Q value. So you know already I have used a big integer because our integer values will be very large. That is the reason I have used everywhere the big integer primitives. And this big B is nothing but this is the object name of your big integer. Okay, so big B underscore P is a value of your P. So what it is going to store? It will store the prime number, because according to our program, it will store the prime number. And here I have given some of the values within that it is going to accept. So here I have given 32 bits of data. So it means that 32 bits of data, it is going to, within that bits of data, it is going to accept and store inside your P value. Similarly for the Q also. Okay, and I have attached the random 1 and random 2 to find out the performance and the efficiency. What is the next step? Next step will be to find out the value of n. What is n? N equals to P into Q. How to multiply? Directly I have used the multiply keyword here. With whom and whom I'm going to multiply? I'm going to multiply P into Q. So you know the value of your n is equals to P into Q. Only the difference is I have used this big integer, big B and all, because that is the object name. Okay, so big B underscore n equals to big B underscore P multiplied with big B underscore Q. So that is my first step over, where I have calculated the value of my n. What is the next step? The next step is to find out the value of your phi of n. But directly I have not written here. First I have to find out the value of my p minus 1. So how I am going to find out the p minus 1? Here I have written in this way. Here you can see p, okay, subtract means minus. Here I have written 1. Okay, and why I have written all these things, the rest of the things, I will explain you. Here, the value of your 1. This 1 also has to store in some of the memory because it is an integer type. That is the reason here it has been written big integer. A new keyword has written to create a memory space to store the value of this, to store this value like 1. Okay, and that things are going to minus subtracted from your P. So that's the reason I have written P minus new big integer 1. Similarly, q minus 1, okay? And all these values are going to store, the p value is going to store in p1, q value is going to store in q1. So I have just given one more new name, big integer, big b, p1, here q1. So p1 is equals to p minus 1, q1 is equals to q minus 1. What is the next step? So next step will be the multiplication of both p1 and q1. So I have just multiplied P1 into Q1. Okay. And I have saved in the new variable name, that is big integer, big P, P1 underscore Q1. Okay. Instead of phi of N, I prefer to write like this to understand. Okay. If you want to replace it in any some other variable name also, you can do it. Now we are going through the finding out the public key and private key. So while I have given the condition, because if the condition is true, it has to follow in this way. You know that we have to find out the value of GCD. Okay. So how we are going to find out the GCD? Here, this is phi of n, right? P, this is the multiplication value, like P1 into Q1. So this P1, Q1, GCD you have to find out with new big integer public key. So whatever the public key, we are going to keep it inside. So that value has to be inside the GCD because that has to be equals to 1. Okay. So that is my condition. So how we are going to give the condition? If the GCD is equals to 1, okay, then here only you are going to give the break. So break and just add your public key. So public key will get increased. So in that case, you are going to get the public key and keep it as a, create the new space and keep the values inside your public key. I hope you understood. I'll just go once again. You are going to give the while condition as true. And from here, you have to find out the GCD, which one, where you are going to create the space for public key. And you are going to find out the phi of n and this public key value. If you are finding the GCD of that, it has to be equals to 1. If it is equal to 1, then you can get your public key, means the value of your E. So here that value, you are going to save it here. Now next, moving towards the next one, how you are going to find out the private key? The private key will be the modulo inverse of phi of n. Whatever we have done, that is my D value, I told you. But however we have calculated in our arithmetical way, in that way we cannot write in the program. So in the program, we have to write in this way, like modulo inverse. So what is the primitive for that? The primitive will be modulo inverse of phi of n. This is the value of phi of n, right? So with that, you are going to find out this public key. Whatever you are going to get it, that will be my private key. So that is nothing but the value of my D. So from here, I got the value of E and from here, I got the value of D. So now I'm just writing system.out.println because I'm going to print the value of my public key and the value of my private key. So I have utilized my object name, a variable name over here. So this is the first program where we are going to generate the key. Okay. We are going to generate the key. So you have written this program in one editor. So now you have to open one more editor and you have to write the program of your RSA encryption and decryption algorithm. How you are going to write here and how you are going to find out the encryption and decryption algorithm? It is also in the same way. We are going to just follow the same algorithm again. So here, as I told you already, we have to import the big integer and here we are going to write the util package. So now my class name is RSA encryption decryption. That's the reason my this program name also RSA encryption decryption dot Java. Okay, so here this public static void main string argument is already I explained you. So now directly going inside the program, here the public key. So the public key will take the value of this space. Okay, so I have created the space, the first place zeroth. Okay, so first integer type, sorry, arguments that will be your string types are have been converted into integer types and created the memory space, which is known as here the value of your public key, that is your E. Similarly, the second place will be your private key, that is the value of your D, and the N value will be the second place, that is the value of your N. So here the next one, what I am going to do is I have to use here ASCII value, because whenever I will convert my plain text to cipher text, that time whatever the value I will okay, so now here you can see we have taken the big V value. Okay, so the value will be nothing but we are going to have this ASCII value, which one will create the new integer. The new keyword is used to create the memory locations and the ASCII value is going to store inside the value val. Okay, then next we have to calculate the ciphertext value and the formula will be the value multiplied with the modulo power. You are going to find out of whom you are going to find out, public key and N. You know that modulo N we have written because message we will give. So ciphertext value, how to calculate? M power D. Okay, M power D. First we have to calculate the ciphertext. C will be M power E modulo N. So that M is nothing but this value. Okay, so power of what we are going to find out? E and modulo N. Okay, so same thing has written over here. So from this you are going to get the ciphertext value. So I will just print my ciphertext value. So here what I have written here, my ciphertext, where it is going to get my ciphertext value from cipher val. Okay, so next is I have to get the plain text value. How I'm going to get the plain text value? I have to write plain text means the message whatever I passed. So I have to write C means the ciphertext value power D. D is nothing but my private key modulo N. Okay. So from here I'm going to find out my plain text value. And the plain text value, we know that it will be same as whatever the message has been passed. So now here you can see int plain value will be this value. It will be in the value integer types. That's the reason we have written it as your integer. Then you are going to write, you are going to print the plain text value and concatenate. This plus we are using to concatenate with the plain val. So now how you are going to execute the program. So you know we have here two programs. To execute the first program, you have to write, this is your terminal, right? So you have to write Java, the first program name, that is RSA key generation. Here I have to pass some key. Okay, anything you can pass. So I have passed here 20. So as I have passed here 20, that is my key. So it will create some public key and some private key values. You can see here the public key is 23 comma some value, and my private key is there are two values. Okay, the comma is there, right? You have to keep this. You cannot close this. And simultaneously, you have to open one more terminal. Okay, so don't you have, because in your Windows screen there will be two terminals. So in the first terminal you have executed this. So you have to open the second terminal there itself, and there you have to write the second output. So Java, the second program name is RSA encryption decryption. The next value is the value whatever you got it here, the first one. What, how much you got here? 23. So here you are going to write that 23 here, right? And that is my public key. Then you have to write the private key. So what is the private key here? You can see the first value and second value. Here the value has come by separating with comma, but here you are not going to write of it. And you have to pass a message. So E value also we have given as there as some 20. Now here also assumptions value, some message value, I have given 10. Okay. So this 10 value has to come out as my plain text. So when we are going to work out with this, we will get the ciphertext, some of the values, and the plain text values as 10, because here also we have passed the message as 10. So from here we can get that whatever the plain text we have assumed, that the same value it has given us as your plain text. So I just repeat the procedure once again. As you have written two Java programs, while finding out the output, you have to open the two terminals. So in the first terminal, you have to write the first program name you are going to execute it. So Java, the first program name, then just pass some assumption value, that is my 20, like my E value. So from here I have to calculate the E comma N. Okay, the values, whatever is their value, some public key, it's not E comma N, it's a some public key values it will give you, and some private key values it will give you. So from the public key, the first two digit wherever the comma will be there, before that the digit whatever is there, that you have to pass in your second terminal value. So here while executing the second terminal, the second program, you have to write Java RSA encryption decryption, the public key value and the two private key values, but don't give anywhere the comma. Okay, so write down, just copy and paste the values, then give the space and pass the message. The message here I have given like 10, you can give anything. Then from here the ciphertext value has been created, and the plain text value, whatever the message we have passed here, that is the same value. If you are getting same, it means your code is working absolutely fine. So this is a procedure of your encryption and decryption and the key generation of your RSA algorithm.